You mentioned if you're reading this, you know, the intro is the legend. You know, mm-hmm. like talking about the legacy. At what point did you say, did you realize that, yo, if I die, I am a motherfucking legend?
Again, I think it was just one of those overly confident statements that felt like a great note to start a album on. I definitely think in the last probably 5 years or 4 years, I've really realized that far after I'm gone from here, that I will be a part of music history. And to me, that is a legendary thing, you know, because there's just so many incredible artists over all these years. And, you know, when I think back of people I used to just look at pictures of when I was like 5 years old or like, you know, and just to think that like people even mention my name in the same sentence as any of those individuals is lets me know that I've accomplished something far beyond probably my wildest dreams, you know.
But that project's obviously riddled in controversy because of Quentin Miller, right? A lot of people feel like, well, he helped you with some songs, and even to this credit, I feel like you're still battling these ghostwriting rumors and this type of thing. That in some sense, I think, does try to tarnish your legacy, whether it's effective or not. Like, how do you look back on that album, and does that still take away anything from that album for you, or how do you view it now when you look at it?
No, I really have, you know, I've really made my peace. I have no embarrassment when it comes to what I did on that album. You know, I mean, I worked with somebody on, I think, 4 or 5 songs on that record. I pulled my weight when it came to my pen. It wasn't like I just, you know, it wasn't like I needed somebody to facilitate, you know, entire ideas. We worked together. And if I need to be the poster child that took all those hits for all my peers hiding behind me that do the same thing every fucking album, that's fine, I'll do it. You know, because there's a lot of people that link up with other people and make records that you guys love, you know? And that's kind of how music is a collaborative thing, you know? It's and I understand in rap, of course, in your comment section, it's a little different because we conduct ourselves, and I still associate myself in that community, we conduct ourselves by a few different rules. We tweak the rules a little bit in the sense that...
If it's a hook, it's okay.
Yeah, it's like, you know, there's things like that, you know. But, you know, with that being said, like, you know, anybody that knows me knows that my strongest talent is writing. That is my strongest talent. I'm not a great singer. I'm a good performer. I've grown into a great performer. But my greatest talent is writing, you know, and that's why people ask me to write songs for them. That's why people like to get in the room and write with me. And yeah, I want to just encourage anybody, like, look, if it makes a great song and you're the one that's voicing it, but it's you and this other person that's cooking it up, you're not doing anything wrong, you know? And that's like, just again, from me speaking to any new artist, like, don't let anybody tell you that you're not supposed to collaborate on music. That's what this is for. We should, you know, whatever gets you to that destination where you have, you know, a great body of work. If you need somebody to write the whole thing and all you do is just go in and track it, there's still artists that exist like that to this day that people love and revere, and they sell out stadiums.
You're saying, that's not you, though.
That's not me, no. I've wrote all, by the way, all my biggest songs and any song that really, really did damage for me, I've wrote every single lyric. So that, like...
The hits, yeah.
Not even... No, the hits and the ones that you would... Like, it's like, I never... I'm not going to collaborate with somebody on any of the timestamp records. I'm not collaborating with anybody on, you know, Marvin's Room or, you know, like, the R&B records that are... You know, other than me and Party. Like, I love working with Party.
When you say the timestamp records, that is, like, the MC, like, the bars, right?
Yeah.
Those are, like... So I think the idea was like try to discredit using MC that all of that doesn't come from your pen.
Of course.
You're saying that comes from your pen.
But again, curated by the people who are ready to see the downfall of Drake. So yeah. Again, just another little like, let's try this angle. You know, it's yeah. Really any, like, again, like I said, I've done studio sessions with people. When I collaborate with people, I always send the idea first. Yeah. You know, I'm the one that picks the beat and goes, yo, here, just put a verse on this and take that for your album or your single or whatever. You know, I put work in. People know me. I'm good for it. Yeah. You know, so that's why I'm never really stressed about, like, that narrative. It's cool. It's fun. Again, it's cool for, like, memes and people that want to laugh and all that dumb shit.
But how did you feel in that moment of Meek sort of putting that out there and then everything goes crazy, right? A guy that was your friend, you know, things get a little hectic with you guys at that point, right?
Yeah, yeah. He was, I think he was in a bad mental spot. And yeah, he just made like a decision to go crazy, you know? It was, if I remember correctly, it was based on a show that I didn't show up for. That was like the tip of the iceberg. I think we had a little miscommunication, and he was under the impression that I'd confirmed that I was pulling up to one of his shows, and I think it was one in Philly. And I didn't show up. And, you know, my management or somebody reached out to say I wasn't coming. And I think, you know, that being coupled with whatever, you know, conversations were happening amongst him and his lady, and, you know, him just kind of getting this idea, maybe I don't fuck with him or whatever, whatever. And, you know, he'll tell you himself, he wasn't in the best mental spot at that time. And, you know, I think he just took a hard left and decided to just go for it and felt like he had enough ammunition to maybe, you know, put a major dent in my armor or decapitate me, you know? And again, I'm really good at channeling that negativity and those pressures into pushing me to a next level where I go into a calculated reactive space.
Charged up, back to back. You almost took the bully position. Like, where y'all at? Like.
Yeah, I mean, I just felt like, you know, in that moment, I was like, all right, well, if we're talking about music, let me just show you better than I can tweet you, you know, or better than I can text you. I'm just going to show you what I'm about. And I don't think anybody really expected me to just jump out there and defend myself and go first. And
twice.
And second. Yeah. I think, you know, Charged Up was a thing that, you know, I was just seeing if it was real. I was just seeing if it was, because, you know, you never know how calculated someone's plan is. Maybe they've been sitting on the record for 6 months, they hated you all this time, and they just want to fry you. Right. And so Charged Up was my way of being like, you know, is it real or is this just like a sporadic, like outburst? You know, yeah, I just wanted to know if it was real, if it was a package or if it was just like maybe like a mistake on his part, you know? And I started to realize that it was...
taking an adversarial stance, in a sense.
Yeah, yeah. And then I had made the decision that I was going to... go again. And I remember I was working on some beat. I think it was like a Boy Wonder beat or something like that. And it was like kind of more like rappy, you know? It was going to be another like 100-bar... thing, and I was with Serena at the time, and we had been talking a lot about her and Sharapova going back and forth over the years, and she had made this comment to me, and she was like, well, look, if you're gonna go again, you know, that beat that's on in there, it's just that, she's like, you gotta finish it. And you know, she's a top competitor. Right. So she was like, you gotta finish it. Like, I'm talking about done, over. And it's gotta be something that everyone that he's with and him have to hear.
Can't ignore it.
Right. Yeah.
You can't do some shit that's just for the moment and then it goes away.
Yeah.
She kind of put this battery in my back, funny enough. And then at the time, just, you know, again, timing. This kid Dax walked in the studio and never met him before. Played a beat, and that was the first beat.
Right.
And it was slow. It was super slow. It was way slower than it was. And then I told 40, like, yo, speed it up a bit. And that was just when we heard that. Mm. Mm. I just went into demon mode.
Right.
Yeah, and then, you know, I don't like to glorify the situation or talk about it too much, obviously, because, but I'm just giving you the background on how it happened. But, you know, I'm not trying to sit here and be like, yeah, my record was something.
You know, it's reconciliation. I mean, the Boston show, you bring him out. Like, a lot has happened after that battle, right? Yeah. I mean, you could write a whole, you could do a whole 30 for 30 on that that battle, right?
But well, yeah, there's a, I mean, by the way, you know, also these things go to another place, right? So, you know, one thing I could tell you firsthand is like, you know, Meek's not a pretender. He's not a joker. He's not like beefing with some of these other rap guys where it's like their story's all made up and they're really not, their character's not like that. Meek's really about that. And so, you know, and I can tell you firsthand, straight up, you know, I'm not gonna, you know, I know obviously he's made a change in his life, but I'll be the first to tell you that. Meek's that guy for real. So it's like, I wasn't beefing with no punk,
right?
You know? And it's like, yeah, for us to be able to turn that around was a big thing. I think we both felt an obligation just to everybody that had eyes on us, all these young kids. We had to turn that around because we know how far it was going,
yeah,
and almost went, you know? So.